welcome back inside our Vancouver Proactive studio. And joining me now is David Copeland, the CEO of Rathdowney Resources. David, good to see you.
Yes, good morning. Thank you. Appreciate it.
And also Andrew Ng, he's the CFO for Rathdowney. Andrew, nice to see you as well.
Great. Nice to see you. Thanks for having us.
Yeah, we're going to talk about your project in just a second. But David, I thought it'd be a good idea to just sort of give us a bit of background on the company.
Certainly. I very much appreciate that. Rathdowney Resources is one of the public company groups with the Hunter Dickinson Group. I'm one of the principals in the Hunter Dickinson Group. And our objective corporately and our ethos is to look for projects that are undervalued and have the potential to possibly go the distance. And we do that through public companies. And Rathdowney is one of those such companies. And we have been moving the company through its project very successfully.
Yeah, tell me a little bit about your project, 100% owned project in Poland. Is that correct?
That is correct. And the question is, why Poland? We made a very cognizant decision to look for bulk tonnage zinc lead deposits that had long life and good economics. There is a class of deposits that fits that venue. They're called Mississippi Valley. I won't go very far into a technical discussion, but they represent a type of mineralized system that are platform reefs, and they'd be like the barrier reef off Eastern Australia. And you have seafloor smokers, which we have off the Vancouver Island, very similar kind of setting. And then you had these reefs that had started to become limestone. And in that process, you had these very hot ascending boiling waters that were full of minerals, zinc, gold, lead, etc. And once they reached these reefs that were now becoming limestone, you had acidic waters meeting basic environment. The minerals would precipitate out. So in terms of deposit type, these become very large and very consistent. And that was the type of thing we were looking for. Poland is also home to these type of systems. It's called the Silesia District. It's in southern Poland. And there are deposits that have been developed there since the 1800s.
Wow. So Andrew, let's hear from you now. There was a PEA done on this project. Can you sort of take us through a little bit of the numbers in the PEA?
Sure, Steve, we can. So in 2014, we had SRK complete a 43-101 compliant PEA, and it was based on 24.4 million tons, which was a subset of the larger historical resource of 70 million tons as confirmed by the Polish Geologic Institute. So we were very satisfied with the results, which was a NPV after tax of US $170 million, IRR 30%, and a payback of less than 3 years, which is very intriguing because on average for the first 3 years, it is free cash flow of US $125 million per year. So this thing pays back in cash and it is very robust, and we are very intrigued, and that is why we are advancing this Olza Zinc Lead project today.
Yeah, tell me also, you've gone to the market to raise some capital as well. Tell me a little bit about that and where you see that capital being utilized.
Sure, Steve. We are on the track right now marketing a $3 million Canadian financing, and those funds raised from this financing will be used to support the work programs and activities associated with obtaining the Polish mining license, which we believe is reachable. And we are definitely marketing. It is challenging times right now, right, Steve? But we are definitely building up some momentum, and we're happy here to talk about that today.
Yeah, David, let's talk about the mining license, because there is a process involved in Poland for getting a mining license. Is that right?
Yes, most certainly there is. And it's actually, we consider it a very straightforward process. There's a number of steps in it, which we're in the process of completing. And that, certainly, as Andrew has said, that's where these new funds will be used. We go through as in most countries, a very good environmental assessment process. We've collected all the data for that. It's in the final stages of publication. That forms part of the submission documents. There's a land use change document as well. And we're advancing on those as we are. A key document for the license is what we would call a project development operational plan. And that involves all the engineering, how we would mine the project, how we would process our materials, where supplies would come from, traffic patterns, all these additives that make for a project development. We're very fortunate in Poland that all the infrastructure is in place. We don't have to build highways. We don't have to deal with putting together electrical systems. That is all there. So that is additive to the process. It's well understood in Poland, and it makes the licensing aspect very much straightforward.
Well, it sounds like it's going to be a very interesting time over the next couple of months for sure with the project, and look forward to hearing more about it as things roll on. David, thank you so much. Great to talk to you again.
Thank you for the opportunity. Much appreciated. Have a good morning. Cheers.
All right, Andrew, thank you as well.
Thank you, Steve.
All right, that's Andrew Ng, the CFO, and David Copeland, the CEO of Rathdowney Resources.